Hello, I'd like to really quickly show you what a letter looks like in kind of a business format. This is a very professional letter format. It's called the block format letter. There's also a modified block format, which changes things a little bit. But whenever you're not sure what to go with, you can stick with the most formal format, and that would be the block format letter. You can't really go wrong with it. So for now, let's focus on this one. I just want to point out what some of the things are here. I've got a letter here. The entire letter is in Times New Roman and size 12. So everything in the letter except for my signature is in Times New Roman and it's in font size 12. The first thing that I've written here is the address. That's my return address. You'll notice it's the address of my school. I don't have to put my name in there because my name shows up down in the bottom. So I've got my address without my name. I skip a line and I put the date that I am sending the letter. I skip another line and I put the address of the person I am writing to. So here's Ms. Kate Riley, the Seattle Times, P.O. Box 70, Seattle, Washington 98111. This is a letter to an editor of the Seattle Times. Skip another line after their address, and then you have your greeting. These greetings start with dear, Mr. or Mrs., or Ms. or Miss, and the last name followed by a colon. So here I'm using Ms. because I don't know if this person is married, which traditionally, if they're married, you would write Mrs. It's kind of old traditional stuff. If they were unmarried, you would write Miss, I think without a period. But you're pretty safe nowadays to just go with Ms. It's kind of the better route, because you don't know what anyone's situation is really. But that was the tradition. I would say either go with Mr., MR period, or Ms. If you're not sure at all, if they're even say it was a name that I couldn't tell if it was a male or female, then you could, or if you don't know the person you're writing to, you could say to whom it may concern. That is also very traditional. So I've got dear and the Ms. Riley colon. Skip a line. So in this format, it is not a comma like you usually see in kind of a friendly letter. In this block format letter, the business style, it is a colon. It's very professional. Then I've got body paragraphs, and I notice I don't indent. Normally, you would see in a book or in a narrative or a story, you would indent at each paragraph, but none of these paragraphs are indented. Everything in this block format is aligned to the left side. I am skipping a line between each paragraph though, not indenting, but skipping a line. And my final paragraph, I can skip a line, and it is appropriate or okay to have one little line in there that kind of thanks the reader or addresses that they gave you some time, or even you could say, I look forward to meeting you if you're setting up an appointment or something like that. So feel free to say something kind of thankful or personal in there. Your closing should be followed by a comma. Only the first letter of the first word needs to be capitalized. So it's the Y is capital, but it's not the S is not capital. You might say yours sincerely. You might just say if you say just sincerely, then you would have a capital S there. You give a little bit of space, like a few lines here, so that you can sign it. If you want to print it out and you're going to send it to them, you can print it out, sign. So leave a little bit of space between your closing, and then you want to have your name typed. Because if you've ever seen my signature, which some of you have, they would not know who this letter was from if they saw my signature. They cannot read David Hunter out of the signature. So you always want to have it written just below. So that's basically the block format letter. Size 12 Times New Roman. It's single spaced, but you do skip a space between each paragraph. You don't indent the paragraphs. Everything is aligned to the left. And some of the big things are your address, the date, the person's name and address that you're writing to, the greeting, your body paragraph, or your whatever your the body of your letter is, the text of your letter. You can say something more personal in here, thanking them directly. Your closing, comma, only the first letter capitalized, your signature, and your name typed.